Welcome, boys and girls. Welcome to church. It's May 29th, the last Sunday of the month. I can't even imagine myself. I am so surprised. Like, I can't believe it. But guess what we'll be talking about today in church? God takes sin seriously. Before we talk about today's topic, remember, let's close our eyes, let's bow our heads, and let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you. Thank you for another beautiful day in the presence of the Lord. We are glad that we are here to listen to your word and understand your word, and we are able to tell our friends and family about your word. Lord in heaven, help us to understand your teachings today. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. You know what's next, boys and girls? It's time to dance in the presence of the Lord. It's praise and worship time. So now let's all get up and start dancing. Don't sit down. Stand up and dance to this wonderful music.
I don't want to be icky.
Ew.
Or sticky like sins.
No way.
I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives. I don't want to be icky. Or sticky like sins. I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives. Should we lie?
No!
Should we fight?
No!
Should we say mean words?
No!
I say no to sin. Should we disobey?
No!
Should we hit?
No!
Should we throw a fit?
No!
I say no, I say no to sins. I don't want to be icky.
Ew.
Or sticky like sins.
No way.
I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives. I don't want to be icky. Or sticky like sins. I want to be pure and clean in my heart where God lives. Should we lie?
No.
Should we fight?
No.
Should we say mean words? I say no to sin. Should we disobey?
No.
Should we hit?
No.
Should we throw a fit?
No.
I say no, I say no to sins. I say no to sins. I say no to sins. I say no to sins.
Because the Bible tells me to. I obey because I love God. I obey because I love my mom and dad. I read my Bible.
Right.
boys and girls, before we talk about today's topic, remember I told you that we're talking about how God takes sin seriously? We have one of our wonderful friends that's going to read the memory verse for us today. Today's memory verse is taken from Ephesians 2, 4 to 5. Boys and girls, let's listen to our friend.
Ephesians 2, 4 to 5. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love that he has for us, made us alive with Christ, even though we were dead in trespasses.
Thank you, friend, for reading the memory verse for us. I hope we all had our pens and our notepad and we wrote it down in our Bibles. Remember, I told you, always have those when you want to listen to the Word of God. And the memory verse today, remember, is Ephesians 2, 4 to 5. I'm going to ask you again if you remember. So, sister, remind your brother. Brother, remind your sister. It is Ephesians 2, 4 to 5. So, let's open our Bibles, as I always tell you, to Ephesians 2. And let's read the Word of God today. Ephesians 2, verse 1. And I read, and you had he quickened who were dead in trespass and sins, wherein in the time past ye walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now walketh in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had our conversation in times past in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and the mind, and were by nature the children of wrath, even as others. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us. So today's text is also taken from Ephesians 2, 1 to 4. You might not understand what I just read to you right now in the Bible verse, but I'm going to explain to you. Because remember, I said God takes sin seriously. And as children of God, remember, we have commandment from God. God gave Moses commandment, and those commandments taught us not to commit sin. So children, we all know what sin is. Sin is lying. Sin is taking what does not belong to us. Sin is bearing false witnesses. You know, sin is something that kills us spiritually. Now, you might ask me, what do you mean people die spiritually? When someone dies spiritually, it means that you don't have the Holy Spirit in you anymore. You cannot communicate with God. And we don't want that, because we are children of God and we love God and we always want to be alive. We always want to be spiritually alive. And being spiritually alive means that we stay away from sin. We stay away from things that tells us that we are bad kids. You know the basic thing that you do in school sometimes, you know, when you see some other kids, because I believe you, my kids don't do that. I believe so. I believe that you are all children of God. And for being children of God, you have the Holy Spirit in you and you're spiritually alive. So sometimes you can teach your friends, you know, when you are in school and maybe your teacher says, sit still and let's do this. Or your parents put ice cream and they say, you know what, Sandra, for example, don't take that ice cream. And because you believe that mommy doesn't really pay attention, or mommy might not know if I take some of this ice cream or if I take a cookie in the pantry, mommy will never know. It's a sin, because you are taking without asking. And if mommy or daddy has said don't take, it means don't take, you know. And if you take something, maybe your brother's toy or your sister's toy, and you hide them because you want to play with them by yourself, and mommy asks, so did you take this? And you go like, no, I did not. Or did you take the remote? No, I did not. That is a sin. That is lying. It is no good. Lying is a sin in the eyes of the Lord. And as children of God, we shouldn't be doing that, because God takes sin seriously. There's nothing like a small sin or a big sin or a little lie. You know, I've heard people say, oh, it's just a small lie. A lie is a lie. There's no small lie. There's no big lie. When you lie, it's a lie. So please, please don't do that. We as children of God always want to be spiritually alive. We always want the Holy Spirit to be inside of us, live inside of us. What do you mean by that? When the Holy Spirit is alive in you, when anybody asks you, they know that you are someone of integrity. Integrity means that everybody knows you are someone that tells the truth. Somebody that likes to do the right thing. Someone that is always you know, pointing out the right things, and you are known to be a good child, you know, you are a good boy, you are a good girl. Not just your parents will say that. When you go to school, your teacher will say, oh my God, Samuel is a good boy. Oh my God, Tina is a wonderful girl. You know, things like that. That is what we want. And I promise you, when you do that, it means that the Holy Spirit is alive in you. And that's what we want as children of God. That's what we ask as children of God. You know, so I hope you all understand this. And I always tell you, even in person, when you come to class, you want to do the best for as a child of God. You want to prove to everyone that I love Jesus, I love God, and I'm not ashamed, and I'm going to do the right thing. Lying doesn't make you look cool. Trust me. Lying doesn't make you look cool. Taking other people's things doesn't make you look cool. No, you don't look cool. You look cool when you tell the truth. You look cool when you are always doing the right thing. That is how to be a cool kid, okay? I promise you, if you do that, you are the cool child. Everyone will be like, oh my God, he's so cool. Oh my God, she's so cool. You know, she is, that is what we want you. As children of God, let them always see the word of God in your life. Let them always see the presence of God, the living God inside of you, living and alive. That is what it means to be spiritually alive. It means you are always doing the right thing and staying away from sin. Once again, our friend is going to read the memory verse for us, and it's taken from Ephesians 2, 4 to 5. Take it away, friend.
Ephesians 2, 4 to 5. But God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love for us, made us alive with Christ, even though we were dead in trespasses.
Thank you very much, friend, for reading the memory verse for us again. I have a story for you to listen to. This is about how God takes sin seriously. So just sit back and watch this video. This video will explain further what you need to understand by how God takes sin seriously. There's no small sin or big sin, as I told you. So sit back and listen to this short video clip.
Paul, a missionary and follower of Jesus, wrote a letter to the church in Ephesus. Paul taught the believers that God takes sin seriously.
First, Paul explained that people are different before they trust in Jesus and after they trust in Jesus. Paul wrote, "Before you knew Jesus, you were dead in your sins. You used to live like the world, like those who choose to disobey God. We all lived like that, doing whatever felt right to us."
Sin has consequences. The Bible says the fair punishment for sin is death. Everyone faces physical death. But people who do not trust in Jesus face spiritual death too. They are separated from God forever. This is very sad news.
But God's plan for people is good news. Paul wrote about this good news. But God, who is full of mercy because of his great love that he had for us, made us alive with Christ. We were spiritually dead, and then he gave us life. You were saved by grace. This means that everyone who trusts in Jesus will have spiritual life, life with God forever.
Then Paul explained what else God has done for everyone who trusts in Jesus. God raised us up with Christ and gave us a seat with him in the heavens. This way, he can show us grace and kindness, both now and for all time.
Paul wrote, "For you are saved by grace, through faith. And this is not from yourselves, it is God's gift, not from works, so that no one can boast. We are God's masterpiece, created in Christ Jesus to do the good works God has prepared for us to do."
Thank you, boys and girls. I believe you all watched that. I know you did. I know, I trust you guys, you all watched that video, and you now understand better what God means, that what it means when I say God takes sin seriously. Before we go, I just want to remind you there's a craft. Ask mommy and daddy or uncle and auntie to print out the craft for you so you can participate in the craft. You can bring it to church and show it to us and see what you've done while you are home today that you didn't come to church. And with that, we have come to the end of today's class. But before we go, we always close our eyes, bow our head, and thank God for today's teaching. Father in heaven, we thank you. Lord in heaven, we worship you. Merciful Father in heaven, thank you for reminding us, for telling us, for we are reminding you, God, that we are going to be true to you. We are going to do the right thing. We love you, and we are going to serve you and worship you and do the right things and tell our friends that we need to do the right thing every day and all day. Thank you, Covenant Keeping God. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Remember, I love you so much, but God loves you more. Thank you.